Of the functioning of the spirit in verse 8. He said, the Spirit of God is like the wind. Yes, the Spirit of God is like the wind, because the wind blows where he wants to blow.
Yeah.
I wish I had a witness here. You can't tell it where to blow. You can't tell it how to blow. Yeah, he blows like he want to blow.
Yeah.
Do I have a witness here?
Yeah.
You can't predict the wind. Yes, preacher, you're kind of in the dark ages. You can predict the wind now. We have instruments that can tell us how fast the wind is going to blow. We can predict the temperature, and we can predict velocity. We can predict all of that. I said, yes, you can tell me that sometime today the wind is going to get up to 30 miles per hour. But you can't tell me exactly the spot that it's going to start blowing 30 miles per hour.
Yeah.
And you can't tell me the exact designation of where it's going to end blowing 30 miles per hour. But I have a witness there. You can tell me it's going to be cloudy, but you can't really tell me when the clouds are going to come.
Yeah.
And you really can't tell me when the clouds are going to dissipate. They predicted rain Friday night, and man, it was a water gust. But Brother Clint, they predicted rain earlier in the week, and the sun was shining. I wish I had a witness here. All I'm trying to say, we don't control the wind. But the wind gives us a pretty good illustration of who the Spirit is. The Spirit is like the wind. The wind is invisible. And the Spirit is invisible. Wait a minute, preacher, the wind is not invisible. When there's a tornado, I can see the tornadic tunnel forming in the distance. You don't see the wind from the tornado. You see the dust that the wind stirs up. I wish I had a witness here. You see, when the Spirit moves, you don't see the Spirit, but you can see the Spirit touching somebody. You may not see the Spirit, but you can see when the Spirit makes me act a fool. When it makes me run and there's nobody behind me. It makes me holler when I really don't have a good reason. Do I have a witness here?
Yeah.
The Spirit is like the wind. Yes, you can't see it, but you can see the effects of the Spirit.
Yeah.
You can't see him, but you sure can feel him. You can feel the wind when it blows, and you can feel the Holy Ghost when he moves. Do I have a witness here? Somebody ought to testify right there. He's real. He's real. I know he's real. Yes, the wind is not predictable, and the Spirit is not predictable. He moves in his own way, and he moves in his own time. And I said he signifies, or rather he signs every conversion experience. In other words, every conversion experience is a unique experience, custom made just for you. You may come up doing an altar call, and you may be told, everybody repeat after me. I believe that Jesus was born of a virgin. He died and was buried in a tomb and rose from the grave. And said, if you believe that, you are all saved. Yes, you all can repeat the words, but you aren't going to be all saved the same way and at the same time. See, God, he examined all of our hearts. God knows what's going on in our minds, and God deals with us individually. Somebody will have one question, and somebody else will have another question, and God to be. I love this illustration because he says that it's not the wind. You see, the wind doesn't blow the same way all the time. Yes, when I was a little boy, they didn't have a whole lot of air conditions. We used to go out and play in the hot sun. I keep telling folk, I never heard my mama say, stay in the house, it's too hot outside. Because the house I lived in, that we were raised in, Brother Clinton, didn't have an air conditioner. We had a big old fan in the window. And I said, Daddy, that fan never blows anything in. He said, that's a different kind of fan. It's supposed to blow or pull the hot air out the house. And the cool air comes in the other windows. I said, I want a fan that blows on me. So I have a witness here. They never said stay in the house. It's cool in the house. They said go outside and play because it was cool outside. Didn't have a whole lot of fat children when I was a boy. I wasn't fat then. I was skin and bone because we ran around in the sun. But we had us a good time. Sometimes we climb up a tree. Sometimes we crawl under a house. But we had us a good time all day long. But when we got real hot and we wanted to cool off, we find us a tree and we stand in the shade. Our bodies full of sweat, standing in the shade. And every now and then, a breeze, oh, I wish I had a minute, will blow up against that wet sweat, and it feels like cooling breeze. There's a big difference from receiving a breeze under that tree and receiving a hurricane wind in the middle of a storm. There's a big difference in receiving a breeze under that tree and standing in the middle of a tornado. All I'm trying to tell you, one has a stronger force, but they're all from the same source. That's why I tell people, don't get all discouraged when your conversion testimony don't sound like somebody else. They may have had a tornadic conversion. They may have had a volcanic conversion. Mine wasn't like that. I had one of those breeze conversions. I can't tell you exactly when it happened. I can't tell you the exact second, but I do know it's real, and that it really happened. It's like a rain. You can come a water gusher down, and then the next day, the ground is hard as a rock, but then sometime, the rain just misting all day long, and the next day, the ground is soaked, so it is.